What's going on, everyone? Elam here, and hey, I got a special video. I'm joined by special guest Kimbapp. Do you want to introduce yourself to everyone?
My name's Kimbapp. I'm from the Philippines. I've been playing Flash Party since probably early this year. I can't remember which month specifically, but yeah, I'm one of the oldest players of the game right now.
Nice. Okay, so who's your main character and why?
When I started playing, my main was actually Yeti, believe it or not, or as he's called now, Miko. But gradually after realizing, you know, this character is not that good because of his huge hurt box, so I switched to Sophia. This was on the first month of playing, actually. And yeah, I was doing good with Sophia, but I felt like her playstyle was not my type.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to pick up Alice. Back then, Alice was really good before Sophia player started doing the offstage counter, which ruined Alice. do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, her Alice's up recovery, yeah, her special, the helicopter, and Sophia, yeah, could run off Sophia and counter it, right?
Yeah. So if you're against a really good Sophia player, it's pretty much impossible getting back on stage.
Yeah, that seems like trouble, man. So, question, are you still using Alice right now?
Right now, I'm not meaning Alice. So, actually, after using Alice, and people at this time, people were really complaining about Magician being broken, yeah?
Right.
During this time, like, literally everybody hates that character.
Mm-hmm.
So, I decided to play Magician because I wanted to know about the character. So I wanted to know its weaknesses. So I decided to play it. And actually, I actually realized I enjoyed playing that character. So that's how I became a Magician main, basically.
Wow.
So basically, in the present, I'm maining Magician, even after the nerfs. I can't say he's the one of the best characters right now, but it's sort of like a comfort pick for me.
Right.
I'm just comfortable using the character, whether I win or lose. So yeah, that's it.
Yeah, Magician's a good pick, man. He's a solid pick. I like that character too. I actually use him myself.
Yeah.
Let me see. So, this recent update, how do you feel about it?
I feel like it's good because it's bringing change and it's forcing players to like adapt and learn. Mostly, in my opinion, players hate it because they just started. You know, they just started with the update and they're not yet used to it. So the game, honestly, the game feels entirely different. They changed a lot of mechanics.
Yeah.
I personally don't view it, but I mean, for me, it's either you adapt or you lose. So
I agree.
I'm fine with the updates, but I do agree with the complaints of some people that they have to fix certain bugs. There are bugs right now that they need to fix. I think they need to prioritize fixing that instead, you know?
Right. That makes sense.
And cause overall, my feelings about the update, I like it.
Good. I like the update too, man. Yeah. Adding those mechanics to the game, it gives you more depth and more options. And when you have more options, that allows, like, you know, more gameplay, not just linear rush down and one-sided gameplay. So, like you said before, yeah. I do understand why people are complaining because they haven't, they weren't used to it.
They aren't used to it yet.
Yeah, and I think the way Flash Party implemented it, it just did a quick 180. Yes, they just gave everyone
everything.
Yeah, they gave you throwing, they get the grabs, they gave you shielding, and they gave you air dodging. Like, here you go, and get used to it. But other than that, I feel like it's definitely a good balance to just the one-sided aggression rushdown play. Now you have two, you know, different play styles you can implement. I feel other characters are viable now. Characters that weren't too viable before having a better opportunity or a fair chance against some of the better characters.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing. Okay, so next question. Sandy.
I personally don't like how this character is designed, but I've seen some players use Sandy and actually beat me. So I don't know. I personally haven't used Sandy, only like 20 matches.
Right.
I don't like Sandy's recovery. If you're used to air dodging upstage and you know, but if you're not, I think it's hard to use Sandy's recovery.
How do you feel about her as like a fighter? Just in general, like her character design versus
some of her moves, or hey, I don't know Sandy's gender, but Sandy's moves, some of them are so, I don't know, I don't, so dumb. Like like the neutral special, I don't think it fits. I don't think it fits with the character design, and I think some of her moves are poorly designed in general. Like the counter and her jabs. I don't know. Maybe I need to play more to realize. But for now, I don't think it's a viable character to use in tournament yet.
Okay. Also, about Sandy real quick. Do you feel she seems like a unique character compared to the rest of the cast? Does she feel like she has more going for her? Like it seems like there was more time put into her. Sandy. Does the character feel like it has?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No.
So the reason why I feel that way is, you know, the character has some unique things on it. That most characters don't have, like, you know, the jab. You can hold the jab and you get the little combo going. You know, you got the little dog.
You can get out of the jab. You can get out of it.
Yeah, but so, you know, it's just like, you know, it brings a little bit something different to the table, something unique. Got the little dog for the assist and little different things like that. I feel like they put some time into the character. You know, personally, do you? After the next character after Sandy, do you want to see something more unique that has like that's different than the main cast before all the other characters came out, like before Chili?
Yeah, I want something different, but I don't know. I personally haven't played Smash like you guys, so I don't know the variations of different character types. Like in Smash, it's very diverse, right? The different characters have different play styles.
Right.
But personally, I think we need another character with a sword of some sort.
I agree, man. I want a sword character. It's not like a character that uses a sword with one hand. No, like not two hands, like one-handed sword, and like, you know, it's like some badass character.
Or maybe someone like Falco for me.
Oh, for Melee, yeah.
Falco for Melee. Because when I played Melee, I used to choose Falco all the time because he's really fun to use, the combos.
Right.
But I don't think that type of character will fly in the game. Since they're veering away from The game developer doesn't want combos.
Right. Well, I mean, you never know what the future holds, man. We're still in early access, so, you know, maybe so a couple months down the line, guy has a change of mind and change of heart, and he wants combos. Who knows? All right, so next question. So the current state of the game. I know we talked about the recent update and how you feel about it, but the current state of the game, like, how do you feel about how the game is currently?
Well, when you ask anyone, they will generally say the game has become more defensive in general because of the shield and how punishable the way that when you attack someone on shield, depending on what move or which character you use, it's very punishable, and it's a very disadvantageous to attack someone who's holding down shield.
Right.
So I think right now the game is too defensive, but we'll see, because, you know, players will adjust their strategy to counter that. I'm excited to see what people come up with.
Right. I agree.
Let me see. Right now you can... Yeah.
What were you going to say?
Right now, like, I've seen some people that have developed styles to counter people who are using shield too much. One thing that I saw is some people, like, when I'm holding down shield, they'll just, like, jump in front of me, you know, float in the air and wait until I drop my shield, then come down and attack.
Yeah, they delay their attack, or they don't attack at all. They land and grab you.
Mix up their attacks, which I think is very smart.
Yes, that gives you more depth in gameplay. So now you don't just have one set of play. So now, you know, people say the game is very defensive, right? But people are doing strategies like that, and now, you know, it's all mind games now. So now you got to know, are they going to do a delayed attack? What are they going to do? You know, so it leaves more room to grow yourself as a player, you know, to see different strategies and things like that.
I agree.
All right. So we're coming down to the last question. So, you know, you can say multiple things. So for the last question, I want to know, what would you like to see added to the game? You know, would you just said something about a character? It could either be, like, you know, a character, a stage, game mode, different. You know, what would you like to see added to the game?
First of all, they need to fix the lag before adding any of that stuff. They need to fix the lag first.
Right.
And the FPS keeps dropping for no reason, even when you own a decent phone.
Right.
Like some people have complained on the server.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think the first two things they need to fix are, they need to fix the ping and the FPS drop.
Mm-hmm.
Now, besides those two, I think I initially heard they were planning on releasing one character per month.
Right.
I think that's good. Mm-hmm. But personally, I want to see more unique stages, you know, like stages with moving platforms.
Right.
Stuff like that.
That's
what I want. Actually, one problem I have with the game right now is there's too much game mode. So there's like 4 or 5 game modes, and the players are going to be split into those 5 game modes, so it's hard to find a match sometimes.
Right.
They should rotate the game modes availability, so like they should only make Brawl or 2v2 available at a certain time, so that there will be more people in 1v1.
Right.
I think that will solve the problems in finding match.
Also, you know what else could solve problems? If you played 1v1 and you played like rank, there's a reason to play rank. They might give you special costume, or they might give you something, a title maybe. You know how they give you titles in certain fighting games. You can add titles to your profile and things like that. Maybe they can give you a reason to play ranked, or give you a reason to play more 1v1 or more 2v2 or more brawl. And
I think a reason why people don't take rank seriously is, like, when you have novice, you play against bots. So, like, daily, you can accumulate points easily when you have nova, because you can play bots, you easily beat them. So I don't think people really care much about the ranking system in this game,
right?
Because of that factor.
Right. Well, I mean, hopefully the game gets overly populated to the point where we don't need bots at all, and we just have, like, a nice player base. Like you mentioned before,
right?
Online, I want to be able to play against people from all over the world with no issues. You know, because sometimes there's, you know, you might want to play against players that use a certain character, and they might be in North America, or they might be somewhere else. So,
can Smash do stuff like that?
I'm sorry?
Can you do that with Smash?
Yeah, not on the one on the Nintendo Switch, but when you play on PC, normally you can play against people from all over the world, you know, with little to no problem, depending on your internet connection. How about
in Melee, people can do that with rollback netcode, right?
Yes. So if we got rollback netcode, then, you know, we might got something going there. I hope you guys are listening at Flash Party. What is it, XD Games or whatever? I hope you guys are listening. Give us a rollback, please. Yeah,
I think what people don't realize right now is the game is actually asking suggestions from the players. So people need to actually go and recommend this stuff, because the devs are really listening to the players' suggestions.
It's a good thing, man. That's definitely a good thing. But yeah, man, I definitely hope they listen to this video, and, you know, me being a player and you being a player as well, we both want rollback. So, you know, if you guys are out there listening, please get us rollback. I want to be able to play people in Southeast Asia. No problem. I'm pretty sure they want to play against a few of us. Yeah, good practice. All right, man. Yeah. What was the five questions? You have anything else you want to say before I close this out? Any shout outs, where people can follow you, social media, anything?
I just want people to play the game, enjoy, don't stress about the losses, just keep on practicing, keep on improving, and you need to realize there's always going to be someone better than you, so you just need to practice more and get better, and I think that no matter how many times you lose, what matters is you need to get up and fight back, you know?
Right.
Thanks. I think that's my mindset going into this game.
That's a good mindset, bro. That's really good, actually.
But yeah. Just play for fun, man. People sometimes, they stress too much about losing. It's not that serious.
Yep. At the end of the day, it's a game, right? We're all here to have fun.
Yeah, it's a game. Yeah, we're all here to have fun.
Right. You guys hear that from Kimbapp. Yeah. He told you guys, play for fun and don't stress. Sometimes I find myself stressing, but, you know, brush it off. Once you lose, you lose. You learn. And you come back stronger. So.
Yeah. True.
All right, bro. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time, man.
No, thank you, man.
No problem, bro. Guys, thanks for listening. And be sure to play Flash Party. I will leave the link in the description and the link to the Discord. And, Kim, thank you so much for your time, man. Appreciate it.
No problem, bro. Got you, man. Thank you.
No problem, bro. I see you guys later. Peace.